hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Atlas was tricked by the hero Heracles, one of whose 12 labors involved the retrieval of some of the golden apples of the Hesperides. Heracles offered to hold the heavens for a little while in exchange for the apples, and Atlas agreed. Upon his return with the apples, however, Atlas refused to take the heavens back from Heracles. Heracles then tricked the giant again by agreeing to take his place if he would only take the sky again for a few minutes so Heracles could rearrange his cloak as padding on his shoulders. When Atlas took the heavens upon his shoulders again, Heracles left. The etymology of the name Atlas is uncertain and still debated. Some derive it from the Proto-Indo-European root, telephone, to uphold, support. Others suggest that it is a pre-Indo-European name. Since the Atlas Mountains fall in the region inhabited by Berbers, it could be that the Latin name as we know it is taken from Berber. In fact, the sun is often called the eye of the sky. And since it sets to the west, the Atlantic Ocean can be called the place of concealment of the sun, or Antalentit. Greeks could have borrowed this name for the ocean and called it Atlantic, and later used its root ATL to form the name Atlas. Atlas is also the presently used name of many objects and places. See Atlas, disambiguation. Since the middle of the 16th century, he is often shown in cartographic atlases. However, it was not he but rather the mythical King Atlas that was depicted by Mercator in the first book to bear the name Atlas, and who gave his name to that type of book. Atlas continues to be a commonly used icon in Western culture and advertising, as a symbol of strength or stoic endurance, such as the superhero Captain Marvel, who was granted the stamina of Atlas as part of his powers. In such contemporary depictions, he is often shown kneeling over on one knee while supporting an enormous round globe on his back and shoulders. The depiction of Atlas holding a large round disc on his back is more accurate, however, since the Greeks believed that the world was flat. The image of Atlas bearing a great burden was used by the author Ayn Rand in her novel Atlas Shrugged, which serves as an important metaphor throughout the novel. A character in the novel says that Atlas is the giant who holds the world on his shoulders, although Atlas actually held the heavens and not the earth.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.